Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Govinsky's Tutorials. Today I'm going to take a little look at clippers and talk about how useful they can be and look at two main uses, one as a sound design tool and the other as a tool to make your tracks louder without causing distortion or other problems that some other methods of making tracks louder can do. So let's just get an example of that first. So for example, like here we've got this. Now, this is just this session band jazz thing. So we want to get that louder, you know, we can turn it up, right? But it's going to get to a point where it's going to start going over zero and it's going to start distorting, right? Now, we can push it into a limiter and increase the input gain. But then we also start to get distortion, you hear that? Or we can start playing around with things like the release and the look ahead. And then we start to get this weird pumping effect, which doesn't sound good, right? So instead, we can use a clipper and basically shave the peaks off, right? So it's the peaks in the audio that stop us being able to make it loud, because the peaks are the thing that's going to hit, you know, zero decibels first, right? So if we can cut off the peaks, and that's what we do with a clipper, just by bringing this ceiling down. So when you open the app, I'm looking here at FAC Clipper by Fred Anton Corvest, works on Mac and iOS. So we bring the ceiling down, as long as we don't bring it down too far, we've now reduced the overall volume, and then we can push that into a limiter without getting those kind of distortion problems. That sounds nice and clean, right? It's loud, but it's clean. It sounds good. So that's one thing that we can use Clipper for, right? Now, the other thing is sound design. So very good for ASMR type stuff. So here I've just got unfiltered audio needle point. I just got some kind of large sounding crackles. And then pushing that pretty hard into the clipper here, you can see I've really pushed that input and the output. And we just got this super loud sound, right? Now let's listen to it on something more harmonic. So let's say here I've got Agonizer. So let's just play this just little bass note here. So again, you know, we could make it louder, just increase the gain, right? But we're going to get to a certain point where we just can't push it any further. But listen now with the clipper. Loud and like super crunchy and cool, because I've cranked the input and I've cranked the output. Played around with the ceiling, right? Now another example, and I really like this one. So here, so I've got audio damage axon 3, and I've just got two nodes playing here, and I've taken the filter cutoff pretty low on each of them and the decay. And it's just extremely low volume, right? So here I'm using the clipper to increase the volume, but also to push that input level and intentionally distort things to get some interesting harmonic stuff going on. Now here I'm adding a bit of reverb on top. And then what I did here was I just recorded a little bit of that into a tape looper and slowed it down to half speed. So we got a nice little half speed loop. And then here I've added a bit juggler. So get some downsampling. Now, that's what that sounds like, by the way, just on the original input, not slowed down to half speed. Also sounds good, right? But I really like that. And then, you know, we could do all sorts of other stuff, like add in another clipper. make it really just super fat. Okay, so let's go back to the first example again. Well, let's go here actually first. So here I'm using AUgenX to generate a sine wave, and here I've got the clipper, but I'm not doing anything. So everything's just at default settings, and let's just look at what this sine wave looks like in an oscilloscope, right? So, I got to take that clipper off there. So, okay, so it's nice sine wave, and we got the nice rounded peak at the top, right? We bring in the clipper. Let's bring down this ceiling. And you see here, basically, the ends are being flattened. So what that means now is that we have less of a spike, right? And, you know, the volume has dropped. So this is just being chopped off at the top. So we're getting a lower volume. We're also getting some harmonics created. So let's look at this spectrogram. So there we've got this just sine wave. We just got the fundamental tone. We bring in the clipper. We start getting all these upper order harmonics, right? Now, one thing I've noticed, mind you, with this FAC clipper, even if I just have it at the default settings, and even if I turn on high quality mode, I'm still getting a little harmonic there. So I don't know why that is, because I think it should be completely clean, no? But maybe someone will correct me on that. I've emailed the dev as well to ask him. But this certainly is normal, you know. You bring down the ceiling, you're going to get these harmonics created, and that's what's making this distorted sound. But we're also getting the drop in amplitude that then allows us to push this output and make everything much louder than we could have done before without going over 0 decibels here. Now we can also push the input in, and then everything will start to sound like very squashed and very distorted, and you know, you may want that, you may like it. Okay, so let's look at this example here. So I'm just going to open up a fresh instance of the clipper. And so we bring this down. So here, everything now that is white, it's not actually there anymore. These peaks are no longer there. It's all just flattened here. So it's made everything quieter. And the only thing is, we need to be careful how far we bring this down. If we bring it down too far, it'll start to sound distorted. And in this particular example, I don't want that. I want it clean. So I'm not going to bring it down too much. I'm also not going to drive the input into it. I'm just going to bring this down a little bit until it still sounds pretty clean. And then, you know, see how high I can push this without getting distortion. If I'm getting too much distortion, then I maybe go back over here and adjust these. Right? So, if we look at one of the other examples, let's look at this agonizer here. I'll just bring this volume down a little bit. So here you see we have this multi-band setup. So in FAC Clipper, we can have single band or multi-band. So if we set it to multi-band, we'll have a crossover point, and you can adjust that, right? We'll have a crossover point, and then we can adjust the ceiling and all the, you know, the ceiling and the knee. So how smoothly it will go into the clipping and change the sound of the saturation or the distortion a little bit and adjust the gain for each one as well. So then, you know, we can get into more experimental territory. So if you see here, you know, I've boosted the gain of the higher band because I wanted to sort of bring out that nice, like, fizzy sound on the top there. So the basic controls you have here, you drive your input in. You can have gain matching if you want, so it'll adjust the output to compensate for the extra input. Here you've got your choice of single or multi-band. Here you set your crossover for the bands. Here you can solo. So here we're soloing just the higher band. Here we're soloing just the lower band. Here, as I say, we can adjust the knee. So here we got no knee and we got a much more extreme effect. Here it is softer. Let's hear the shape. Not really hearing too much difference on that particular one. Let's try this upper one. Maybe a little bit. Probably maybe not the best example for it, this one. And here's the gain. And then we have a mix knob, so we can mix the dry and wet. And we've got our output. We can bypass the effect and we can turn on this high quality mode. Though, like I say, even with high quality mode on, there is a little bit of aliasing there. I'm not that familiar with clippers, so I don't know if that's unavoidable. But yeah, it's pretty interesting, you know. So you got those two completely different uses. One to help you make things loud but keep them clean, and the other to go much more bonkers and experimental. So hope this was useful for you. If it was, smash the like, etc., guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy. Cheers.